Hello everyone, I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel, EE Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is Direct Current Machines EMF Equation. It is well known to us that when the armature of a DC machine rotates in the magnetic field, an EMF is generated in the armature conductors. So in this short lecture, we will deduce the expression for the generated EMF. Let us consider that phi is the flux per pole in wafer. P is the number of main poles in DC machine. Z is the total number of conductors in the armature of DC machines. Since a definite number of conductors are put in each armature slot, therefore, the total number of armature conductors can be calculated by multiplying the total number of armature slots with the number of armature conductors per slot. Further, A is the number of parallel paths in the armature winding, where the number of parallel paths in case of lap wound generator is equal to the number of main poles in the DC machine. On the other hand, the number of parallel paths in case of wave wound generator is always 2, irrespective of the number of main poles. This is to remind you that the concept of parallel paths has already been discussed by me in one of my short lecture in this series. Furthermore, the symbol N represents the speed of armature rotation in RPM. Since flux per pole is phi and number of poles is P, therefore, the flux cut by each armature conductor in one rotation would be phi into P, and we have designated this by d phi. Since armature rotation in 1 minute is N, therefore, we may calculate the speed of armature rotation per second as N by 60. Now, since n by 60 rotations are there in 1 second, then the time required for one rotation would be equal to 60 by n, and we have designated this by dt. Thus, we may now calculate the average EMF generated per conductor equal to d phi by dt. So, by substituting the values of d phi and dt in this expression, the average EMF generated per conductor is calculated as phi p over 60 by n. We know that the generated EMF in a DC machine is nothing but the EMF generated in any parallel path of the armature winding. Therefore, the generated EMF that is easy can be calculated by multiplying the average EMF generated per conductor with the number of conductors in each parallel path. We have already calculated the average EMF generated per conductor as phi p over 60 by n. On the other hand, dividing the total number of armature conductors with total number of parallel paths would result into the number of conductors in each parallel path. Thus, we have the equation for generated EMF as Eg is equal to phi z n p over 60 a. Now for lap wound generator, a is equal to p. You people must note a trick to remember this. Just write lap, l a p. Now omit l so as to create in your mind a is equal to p. When a is equal to p, we may express the EMF equation for lap wound generator as phi z n over 60. On the other hand, for wave wound generator, the number of parallel paths is always 2. Therefore, the EMF equation for a wave wound generator can be expressed as phi z n p over 120. Once again, this is to remind you that the generator action and motor action occur simultaneously in DC machines. In view of this fact, whenever a DC machine is operated as a motor, an EMF does induce in the armature conductors termed as back-EMF or counter-EMF. This concept has already been discussed by me in one of my short lectures in this series. Now, it is worth mentioning that the expression of generated EMF remains the same no matter whether the DC machine is operating as a generator or as a motor. Since in case of DC motor, the generated EMF is termed as back EMF. We may write the expression for back EMF as EB equal to phi z np over 60 a. It is also worth notable that for a given DC machine, the quantities Z, P, and A are constants. Therefore, generated EMF EG or back EMF EB is directly proportional to the flux per pole and speed of armature rotation. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.